Yvon Lambert has been brewing beer in Pornic for 5 years.
I studied brewery in Belgium, and I met my wife, and we came back with some Belgium recipes, and we adapt to the Brittany's taste.
The brewing process begins with malt. Using malt roasted for varying levels of time will produce different types of beer. Light and dark, for example. The gram malt is boiled, causing the starches within it to break down into sugars, a vital part of the fermentation process. Hops, in this case concentrated, add flavour, aroma and bitterness. The yeast causes the sugars to turn into alcohol. And with the brewing process complete, Ivan's beer is ready to be bottled and conditioned. Ivan makes 5 types of beer, including light and dark and traditional continental fruit beers. I'm sure similar local Breton beers made it down the back of my throat in my student days. He makes 50,000 litres a year, and it's only available around the coastal region of Pornic en Nantes.
À votre santé.
Another good reason for stopping off in Brittany.
Now, for me, you can't beat local brew. So you're going to use this to make a kind of like a posh fish and chips?
We've got some lovely cod cheeks in beer batter with a lovely sort of chunky tartar dip.
Now, these are similar to what we used with the old monkfish cheeks, but slightly smaller.
Slightly smaller. Obviously, the fish is bigger. Monk heads are massive, aren't they?
Yeah.
So we had a big cheek. But again, a very sweet piece of meat, and it's much underused, and I think that here we go, we've got to encourage the use of it back home.
Well, fire away. I think, like Martin says, they're very much underused, and I think we should use more of them. But if you can get them, buy them, because they're really, really good value. Okay, so you've thrown in the yeast.
We've got a bit of fresh yeast, and then this lovely beer.
Yeah.
And what makes it crispy is cider. Well, not cider, it's vinegar. And it's the vinegar that makes that crispy in the batter, because as it evaporates, as it cooks, it goes through the batter and makes it crispy. And you need about that much. You know, it's about a teaspoon. So
okay.
five mil into the beer with the yeast. A good pinch of salt.
Yeah.
And a good pinch.
Not too much, because you don't want to kill. The salt will kill the yeast.
Yeah. And the sugar actually makes the yeast grow. So it's a balanced thing. But also the sugar, when it cooks, it caramelizes because it gives it color.
Yeah. Okay.
So you whisk that in, and just to break the yeast down, and then we just rein in a bit of plain flour.
What's your experience of France? I mean, it's the same as mine? Or
well, yeah.
Did you train here when you were a young kid? Or
I didn't, actually. I did my training in Switzerland.
Right.
I went to Switzerland. But it was...
Use a lot of French ideas over there.
Yeah,
though,
I think I was trained very classically. College was very, you know, classically French dishes.
Yeah.
But I think what I've noticed is walking around the markets is there's so much more variety and passion from the people that are selling the stuff as well, you know. Anyway, you see what happens is you whisk it in, but already the bubbles start because of the beer. As the yeast starts to work, it will start to rise up a little bit. There we are.
Okay.
So I need to set that aside. And while that just warms through, then we're going to get on with the
now
cheeks.
You're going to marinate the cheeks, are you?
Yeah, well, I'm going to put a little bit of dill and a little bit of garlic. This is new garlic. This is the fresh garlic. Still soft. It hasn't been, you know, hung up to dry out.
Yeah.
So it's a much sort of sweeter, gentler sort of a flavour that comes from it. And what I'm going to do is just roughly chop that up. You don't actually need to skin this too much because everything's so soft. And it's more for the flavour. We're just getting that delicate flavour out of it. So that's going to go into a bowl. And then I'm just going to trim up the cheeks and put those in as well. So
now, this is a great dish that you could do as a starter, but it's kind of, you know, alfresco sort of stuff.
Yeah.
Everybody dives in, a bit like the pot of fur that I cooked earlier.
Yeah, that's it. I think what we're going to do is treat this more as a like you said, a starter with a tartar dip.
Okay.
Right, lovely bit of dill in there. Nice bit of fresh dill. And again, what I need to do is just take, with this cheeks, you can see they've got this little bit of sinew. So I need to remove that, otherwise that shrinks up and goes very chewy.
It's a bit like what's on monkfish as well, you get that sinew on it.
Yeah.
You need to take that off.
Just turn it over. Once you find it with your finger, then use the point of the knife and just slide it through. And then you just remove it without any waste.
Like you said, we were going to do chips with this, but it would be a bit sort of, well...
It would.
Too English, wouldn't it, really?
Yeah.
So I thought I'd do tartar sauce, which is kind of like English as well, isn't it, really? But but French, we've got some beautiful capers that we got at the market. I've got a selection of herbs, parsley, a little bit of chives, some gherkins, lemon, just simple little mayonnaise, 3 egg yolks, a bit of the old cider vinegar. And I'm just going to whisk in the oil, really. It's nice and simple. Now, do you just dry marinade that sort of those cheeks?
Yeah.
No need to add any oil to it. Nothing.
No, not at all really, because you need to cook them quite dry so that they don't take on too much flour before we deep fry them. And the herb is you know really is what you want. It doesn't have to be you know dill. It could be parsley. Tarragon's nice.
So the common mistake is with mayonnaise, really when people are making it, the more oil you add, the thicker it becomes. And if you want to offset that, slacken it a bit, just add a touch of water just to bring it back. But I suppose you want quite a thick mayonnaise.
Yeah, we need it thick because by the time all the our little bits of gherkin and caper and stuff go in, it's going to slacken it down a bit. So thicker the better. Because we're using it as a dip as well, we need it to be able to sort of stick to the batter. Right, so what I've got here, I've got all the cheeks, they've been trimmed up. We've got our garlic and our dill at the bottom. I'm going to just put some black pepper in there as well. No salt, because we're going to salt after we've cooked. So, plenty of pepper. I'm just going to give that a good mix in and sort of massage all of those herbs and that garlic into the fish.
Now, if people are doing it at home, just to speed this along a bit, put it in an airing cupboard or something like that, just somewhere warm, really.
The only recommendation is really you can leave your beer out. Keep it in the fridge. If you're going to do a beer batter, then pop it in the kitchen the day before and it will be nice and warm. That always, you know, gets the yeast working straight away. You can see already there's sort of bubbles starting to form in it. And those bubbles are just, if you give it a tap, they sort of rise to the surface and burst. And the same thing with the fish, you could do this the day before. So what you're going to get is that lovely flavour is going to penetrate into the cheeks.
So the capers and the gherkins have gone in. Give this a quick mix. Look at that. That's a proper tartar sauce.
Nice and chunky, just what we want. Okay, so what I'm going to do with these, we've got our marinated bits of cheek. We're just going to pop that into some plain flour and then just shake off the excess, and that goes into the batter. I'm just going to give that a little mix in.
Yeah, fire away.
And what that does is just coats it all, and then we've mixed that all in there. And now we're just going to drop these in bit by bit. And
these, what, 2 minutes?
2 minutes. I mean, the thing is you want to get good colour on them and the fact that they're going to cook nice and evenly. So, and when they're nice and golden and they're floating, that is really when they're done. Look at that.
Tell you what, if this was in England, we'd have a queue of old dears sat there with their handbags waiting. Fish and chips. Fish look and at chips. That, eh? The way that you made that batter is interesting, but people say that it's either made with just beer, self-raising flour, just yeast, but you've kind of added the whole lot together, basically.
Yeah, I think beer gives you the flavour and a depth and that moussey sort of finish, where the yeast actually guarantees it. It's almost like a guarantee.
Yeah.
And sugar, like I said, for colour, the vinegar, keep it crispy. You see, look, they're lovely. It's just starting to come together now. I'll start lifting these out.
I'll put the old tartar sauce on the plate.
Great.
That looks absolutely fantastic. Top man, well done, mate. So the great thing about this stuff is that it's kind of like British beer. It's much stronger, more like an ale.
Yeah, it certainly smells.
This puts hairs on your chest. Not that you need any more hairs on your chest, but you know what I mean. But thanks for coming to France. It's been worth the effort.
Oh, I'll say, really good fun. I'm in a fishy dream. I don't want to go home.